Hey, this is the yeast experiment setup. We're starting with three empty glasses. They're labeled A, B, and C. I have to do this a little different than the instructions show. We have some regular sugar, same that you would bake with, and a teaspoon. We're going to put no sugar in the first glass, A, and we're going to put a pinch of sugar into glass B, and then we're going to use a full teaspoon for glass C. Once we add that, we're going to need to add some yeast. Yeast is what we use to make bread with. So the yeast is kind of granular. It's dry, but it's a living cell, and it kind of wakes up when it gets into water and has some food. So the amount of yeast we need to use is a tablespoon. So I'm going to scrape that off the top to make sure that it is a even tablespoon for each glass. So the no sugar glass A gets a teaspoon, or tablespoon, excuse me. The B gets a tablespoon of yeast with a pinch of sugar, and C gets a tablespoon of yeast with the teaspoon of sugar. We're going to add water. The instructions say to add 40 milliliters of warm water. The water is warm, but I added a little bit more because it didn't seem like enough water. So I just made sure that the water levels were even. So when you look at this, you'll see that we're starting with about the same amount of water in each glass. Once that's done, we're supposed to stir it with a wooden stir stick. I didn't have that, so I just kind of swirled each one. So here's A being swirled. So now that's mixed. And then we have B. Going to mix that up so that everything kind of dissolves and gets wet. And C, so everything dissolves and gets wet. So once that's done, we're going to let it sit. And it's supposed to be for about a class period or part of the class period, but I'm going to let it sit for close to 20 minutes, and you can watch the remainder of that. Let's look at it. You'll definitely want to look at the end of this video to see how much the foam got to if you're anxious and don't want to wait for the whole thing. So now that the experiment is basically done, we're going to measure the amount of yeast foam that was produced at the top. So it's been about 19 or 20 minutes. The first glass A has about a quarter inch of foam, something like that, a little bit less than a half inch. Second glass definitely has about a half an inch of foam, and that's glass B, so half an inch of foam. And then glass C has at least an inch and a half of foam, so quite a bit more there. So that's the end of the experiment. You'll be able to answer your questions with that.